The remarkable thing is that we have a choice every day regarding the attitude we will embrace for that day. We cannot change our past. We cannot change the fact that people will act in a certain way. We cannot change the inevitable. The only thing we can do is play on the one thing we have, and that is our attitude.
I'm challenging you to make the most of this day. Live it like it could be your last. Don't spend it negative and defeated. Enjoy today.
And no matter how bad things are in your life, there's always something you can be thankful for.
What's going on, abnormal athletes, and welcome back to another video. You just saw my usual morning routine, so I think it's also really important to prepare yourself mentally as well as physically. So that's my usual routine. All right, now I'm gonna train a client and then I'm gonna go off and do a food shopping, okay? So I'm gonna get some fruits, some meats to prepare for throughout the day, okay? So this video is gonna be like a full day of eating. So hope you guys enjoy it. So we're back home now. Just got the fruit over here. We've got the meat in the freezer because we're gonna freeze some of the meat for tomorrow. But yeah, we literally got 5 avocados for £1. 5 for £1 and 2 pineapples for £1 as well. So that's gonna last me 2 days. The watermelon was £1.50 as well. That's gonna last me another 2 days. So I'm telling you guys, you can eat healthy for cheap. You just need to find the right places. Go to your local markets, your local butchers. There's definitely quality, cheap sourced foods there. Quick tip for you guys, if you're in your farmer's market or anywhere where they sell fruit, to check if your fruit is ripe. If it's a pineapple, one of these stems or stalks, whatever you call them, basically if you pull it out, it should easily come out. So when you pull it out, it should look like this. It means it's nice and ripe, okay? Alternatively, if you're getting avocados, if you pull out the little pip in one of these, it should be green, and that means it's ripe. And then if you pull it out and it's black, it means it's rotten. So again, just a quick tip for you guys, to make sure that you pick the right fruit and vegetables, okay? So my first meal, I'm gonna prepare myself a half a watermelon with some pineapple, and I'm also gonna make a smoothie with some avocado, bananas, and some other stuff, okay? But first, we're gonna cut up the fruit, okay? Now, we're gonna cut it especially my way, ninja style way. Let's cut it. Hey, hey. Next up, we're gonna make ourselves that shake, okay? So I've got the fruit out on the table now, we're just gonna make our shake. So all you're gonna need basically is some almond or coconut milk, an avocado, banana, some honey. I'm gonna use Huel, or you can use any form of protein powder. I'm gonna actually use plant-based protein powder next week because I'm running out of Huel and I'm not too fond of it anymore. So again, this is a meal replacement if you wanna up your calories. And all you're gonna need as well, well, for me personally, I like to include some form of vitamins. So this is like a supplement I'm taking at the moment. It's really good, Dr. Schultz. I'll keep this in the description below for you guys to check out. But again, I just find it gives you, you know, an extra boost of vitamins in my diet. So I'm gonna blend all of these and then I'll show you what that looks like. You're on the track, boys. Alright guys, so we've made our shake now, and then we've got the pineapple and the watermelon. So usually I just like to take the watermelon out with a spoon and just eat it like a bowl, really. So that's our first meal of the day. We're now going to prepare our stew and some more food for later on. Now we're going to make a special hot pepper stew. All you're going to need is basic chopped tomatoes, so you can get them in your local supermarket. You're going to need some red onions, hot chili pepper, vegetable stock, and some spices. So the spices I've got are garlic powder, ginger powder, and curry powder, okay? And not to forget salt and pepper. And we're just gonna prepare this, okay? So let me show you how to make it. So I forgot one last ingredient. We're gonna add a little bit of thyme, okay? So just a little bit of thyme. So you blended everything. Now, because this is hot pepper stew, we want it to be hot, fiery. We want to have that little kick to it, yeah? So we're gonna taste it and see how spicy it is. Ooh, okay, it's got a nice little kick. If you can handle spice, then add some more. If you can't, then lay off the chili. Alright, now what you're going to do is have yourself a pot ready. I'm just going to pour some olive oil in. You're going to heat this up, make sure it's nice, not the pan. And then you're going to put a bay leaf inside and basically just let that heat up until it's sizzling. Once that's sizzling, you just then pour all your hot stew into the pot. Once the hot pepper stew is boiling, in the meantime, we're going to prepare the chicken. So I've done this before in my other previous 4 Day of Eating video. So make sure you wash your chicken, put some lemon over it, you know, really take off any excess skin. So make sure it's really nice and clean. Once you've done that, you've got all your seasoning here. We've got salt, pepper, all-purpose seasoning, of course, olive oil and some marjoram along with garlic. So what I'm going to do is just mix everything together. Guys, now we're going to put this in the oven to roast for around 30 to 40 minutes, and in the meantime after that we're just going to prepare our sweet potato and broccoli as well, because that's going to be our prepped meals for the day. So now the hot pepper stew is cooking, chicken's in the oven, we're going to prepare lunch now for ourselves and a portion to take away from outside. What we're going to do is basically prepare the chicken same as like last time, just season it with all-purpose, bit of salt, pepper, marjoram as well. And then now we're gonna create the breaded chicken. So what we're gonna do is add have a little spelt flour here. We're just gonna place it on the plate. Yeah, that's fine. And then now we're gonna crack our egg. Twist that. And now, so we're gonna prepare our breaded chicken. Guys, now we've prepared the breaded chicken, so all we're going to do is just stir our stew. We can't forget about that, so we're just going to stir it a bit. And again, let it boil for a longer period of time. And lastly, we got to open the oven, turn our chicken over, just to make sure it's evenly cooked on both sides. Woo! Damn that heat! So I've turned up over all the chicken and now I'm going to put it back inside into the oven. Alright guys, final steps now. I've got some sweet potato that I've chopped and I'm going to just basically put some rosemary on now. So I'm just going to take off some rosemary and just sprinkle it across. And we're just going to finish off with some olive oil. Extra virgin olive oil. Alright, now I'm just going to put it in the oven. So alongside the chicken. Ooh, let me not play myself again. Alright, and next up we're going to fry our chicken to make schnitzel. In our pan, we're going to fry our breaded chicken, so schnitzel, to make schnitzel, okay? So what we're going to do is just lay one, just face down. Again, the oil should be hot, the pan should be hot, should be sizzling straight away. Just going to do this for the rest of them. Be on the track, boys. Alright guys, so we've also got broccoli on the boil. So as you can see, just here, I'm going to cover it, and again, it's going to boil for around 5 to 10 minutes. Alright guys, nearly there, last few steps. Basically what we're going to do now is just put our roast chicken into the hot pepper stew. So this is going to be for dinner. So we're just going to gently grab a few and just place them nice softly inside the stew, okay? On the track, boys. Alright guys, so that's one meal prepped. That's going to be for lunch when we're outside. And I'm gonna eat something now, which you'll see in just a sec. All right, guys, this is the finished product. So we have our meal prepped for later. We've got lunch now, which we're gonna eat, and we've got a Vivo Life protein shake. Done. Session done. How you feeling, bro?
I'm feeling so fucking happy, man.
Learning your first muscle up?
Yeah. I did.
That's it, man. We out here, Westbourne Green. Yeah. Last meal of the day. We've got the stew and a roast chicken with rice that we made earlier for dinner, and we've got a protein shake. This is the last meal of the day. It's about that time now, people. We've come to the end of the video. Hope you all enjoyed it. That was my full day of eating, what I eat during the day. Again, comment, like, share, most importantly, subscribe to the YouTube channel. We've got a goal of 100k subscribers by the end of this year, so keep subbing, keep showing some love. Again, comment, like, share. And I will catch you guys next week with another video. I'm so tired, so I want to go to bed. Catch you next week. Peace.